yes, dear, I have spotlighted the screen of the ingredients. So let us just discuss the ingredients that will be needed for today's workshop. For the salad burger, we will be requiring a burger bread. We would require slices of onion and tomato. We would require vegetables like shredded cabbage, shredded carrot, and finely chopped capsicum. You can change the vegetables according to your taste and preferences. If you don't like something, you can opt to leave it, or you can add other veggies of your choice too. That's totally up to you. We would require softened butter at room temperature.
Ma'am?
We would require mayonnaise. We would require cheese spread. This is optional. If you add cheese spread to the mayonnaise, it tastes better. But if you don't have cheese spread, you can use only mayonnaise also. We would require salt and pepper to taste. And some basic vessels like a knife, a plate, wherein we would assemble our burger, and also a toothpick. Yes? Yes, tell me.
And bread, can I see this, how to make?
Yes.
What, dear?
Yes,
I don't have a bread also. So can I see?
Yes, yes. If you don't have the ingredients, you can just watch and learn for today. And you can make later whenever you get the ingredients ready. So it's okay if you even just watch it and learn it for today. No problem. All right. So let's begin. I hope everybody is ready with the ingredients. We had given the ingredient list much in advance. So let's begin with the salad burger. Since this is a no-gas cooking flameless session, we are skipping the fried burger patties, which is usually there inside. So we are making a healthy salad burger, which does not require any cooking or any flame for making this. So it's safe enough for all the kids to make on their own. Kids will learn to make an independent meal for themselves. So here we go. So the first step is we take the burger bun and we slit it horizontally. Carefully, you all can do it with a butter knife that's not sharp, or else you can use a knife under parent's supervision. Carefully, you will just cut open your burger like this.
Hello.
Next step is you need to apply butter on this. So the butter should be soft. It should be at room temperature so that you can apply it easily. So we will apply a layer of butter on this.
Ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, sorry, I joined just now. I joined a little late. What are we doing?
So we are making salad burger. So I have just begun. This is the first step. I have just cut the burger bread and I'm applying butter on it.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. So now, after applying butter on this, we will prepare the center filling of this. So for that, we will use a mixing bowl. the mixing bowl, we will take mayonnaise. So I'm taking around 2 spoons of mayonnaise. You can alter the proportion according to your taste. I'm adding 1 spoon of cheese spread to it. So this will give a nice cheesy flavor to this. We will stir this together and ensure that this mixes properly. Next, we will add our chopped vegetables into this. So I'm adding a little capsicum, I'm adding a little grated carrot, and I'm adding shredded cabbage. So vegetables also, as I told you, you can take of your choice, and the quantity also you can alter. If you don't like too much vegetables, you can put less of them. If you like, you can add more of them. But you have to ensure that they get mixed up with the mayonnaise properly. The mayonnaise should be so much that all the vegetables get coated with it. So the vegetables should not be dry. See how this has got coated completely. Now we will add salt and pepper to taste. So I'm putting a little salt and a little pepper. So here it is. And I'm just mixing this. So this is the filling which is ready. And now, in case you have a lettuce leaf, you can keep a lettuce leaf in the base. Due to lockdown, it was not available, so I don't have it. So if you have a lettuce leaf, you can keep it. On that, you will spread your mayo salad. So you will spread this generous amount because this is the only filling in your salad. So it has to be thick enough. So this is the main taste of the burger. So this filling, you have to put a good amount. Now on this, we will place our slices of onion and tomato. So I'm placing the tomato slices and then I'm placing the onion slices. Yes?
Ma'am?
Yes?
Patties?
Pardon?
We will not put patties?
No, that's what I told you. That instead of the patties, we are putting this salad, mayo salad. That's the whole thing. The replacement of the patties is the salad which we put in mayo and cheese. So that's the filling used here. Because this is a no gas cooking. This is more a healthy version. This is a healthier version. So on these slices again, you can just put some salt. Next, we would require a cheese slice to complete this burger.
Teacher,
yes,
I did use sauce and cookie, yes, and bread. And I use cheese.
Very good. So once I finish this, I will be just coming to your screens in case you want me to check. So now I have placed the cheese slice. I'm putting ketchup on this side of the burger. Spread it. Then put this upside down here. And now just put a toothpick here in the center so that this whole thing comes together. So our salad burger is ready. So any questions? Does anybody have any questions regarding this?
No, ma'am, not any questions.
Anybody who's making along? Anybody who's making the burger? So I'll come and check on your screen.
I did.
Okay, please name yourself. We'll spotlight you. What's your name, dear?
Ma'am?
Yes?
Can you name A-N-A-Y, go to that place, then you will know the name.
Okay, so Anay, is that your name?
Yes.
Okay, Anay, let me check. Yes, Anay, can we see the burger?
I don't have the material, so I did make a sandwich.
Okay, let me see the sandwich that you made. Very nice. Can you just sit down? I'll take a picture. Please sit down and hold the sandwich in your hand. That's a lovely chef cap you're wearing. Just hold the sandwich in your hand, Anay. Ah, that's a small piece. There's the whole sandwich. There is the whole sandwich, Anay.
He already ate half, ma'am.
Okay, let us see half of it in his hand at least.
Okay, so he made this.
Okay, so just let him hold that big piece in his hand.
Hold the piece in your hand.
Yeah.
Hold nice. So
smile. Anay, smile, please.
Put up face in niche karo.
Smile, please. Thank you. So since you ate it, how is it tasting? Let us know.
Still, na?
How is it?
Are you enjoying it? Keep it.
Oh, great. Great. So you're enjoying it. Good to know that. Okay. So anybody else who's making it? Anybody else who has made? So we'll spotlight you and check. Pardon? Aishwarya. Okay. Let's see what Aishwarya has made. Very nice, Aishwarya. Can you smile, please? I'm taking a picture.
Smile.
Very nice. Thank you. So even you can taste it and tell us how it is, whether you're enjoying it or not.
It is nice.
Give me a thumbs up if it's nice. Yummy. Good. So all the little chefs have made a tasty burger. Good. Anybody else who's making it? Is there anybody else who's making along? All right. So, any questions? It's okay, Aditi, if you don't have the materials to make the burger. If you don't have the ingredients, you can just watch. No problem. You can make it later, whenever you get the ingredients. All right. So, our main burger is ready. Now we'll proceed with the Oreo mousse.
Thanks, Mango's night class.
All right, thank you for the feedback. So we have still another thing to make, and that's the Oreo mousse. So should I proceed with that, or is anybody still making the burger? Should I wait or proceed?
Ma'am, you can proceed.
All right. Thank you. So for the Oreo mousse, we'll just go through the things required. We will require a transparent glass, either a glass made of plastic or a disposable glass, anything will do, but it has to be transparent so that the dessert is seen through it. Next, we would require Oreo biscuits. A small packet of Oreo biscuit is sufficient for 1 or 2 cups of dessert. Next, we would require whipped cream. So the whipping cream is different from the Amul or the cooking cream that we use. So don't get confused between the two. So we need the whipping cream. Yes?
Ma'am, I don't have the whipping
cream. Okay. But we will need that there, because without it, the mousse is not possible. So you can just watch it for now and then make it later. See, the whipping cream has to be whipped either by the whisk or by the electric beater till it is stiff like this, and it has to be thick and fluffy. Aditi, milk won't do because we need a thick fluffy cream like this. This will be the base of the mousse. Yes?
If we don't have whipping cream, then what should we use?
Do you have ice cream at home? You can use vanilla ice cream. You can use vanilla ice cream instead.
Okay, ma'am.
So this is the whipping cream consistency. It needs to be thick and fluffy. Okay. Next is, we would require a piping bag. This is optional. If you have a piping bag and a big mouth nozzle, it will be nice to pipe out the mousse. It will come out in a good design. If you don't have, no problem. So I am using a piping bag and a nozzle for piping out my mousse later. And some decoration like any chocolate and any colored sprinklers if you wish to. So you can use anything for decoration if you want to add decoration on top.
Ma'am.
Yes.
The things you required, that don't I have. But I did have this. I made this morning with my mom. I helped my mom. This one, see.
Okay. So chocolate, what did cake you make? Okay, wow. That's very nice. So we'll check that a little later. Once we are done with the Oreo mousse, I'll come and see what you have made. Okay, I'll come to your screen and check. So step number one is, we need to crush this Oreo biscuit. So with the cream, so along with the Oreo biscuit cream, I'm putting the entire packet of this small packet of Oreo. It has around 5 biscuits. I'm keeping 1 biscuit for decoration, and the rest of it, I'm just grinding it in the mixer. So just give me a minute. Yes. Yes, tell me.
We can grind the Oreos with cream only?
Yes, we can. I'll show you how it looks. 1 minute. So here it is. So along with the cream itself, I have just done the grinding. See? So it's a fine powder. I'll just show it to you. See, like this. It becomes a powder like this. Next step is to prepare the Oreo flavored mousse. So, take a mixing bowl. Take the whipping cream around 1 cup of whipping cream. This I'm making only 1 dessert glass, so around this much cream is sufficient. If you are making the quantity of more dessert glasses, then accordingly you will take more cream. So this is around 1 cup of whipped cream. Now in this cream, I am adding Oreo biscuit powder. So I'm adding around 2 spoons of Oreo biscuit powder. This also you can alter according to your taste. If you like Oreo, you can add more Oreo for a stronger taste. And if you are not very fond of Oreo, you can add milder version of Oreo to keep it a little light taste of Oreo. So here is my Oreo cream ready. Another option is to add a little chocolate sauce in this for flavor. If you want to also make this a little chocolatey, you can add a little bit of chocolate sauce in this. So that's optional. Since I like it a little chocolatey, I am adding 1 teaspoon of chocolate sauce to this. So I'm adding Hershey's Ready chocolate sauce.
Mom?
Yes?
We can mix Hershey's?
Pardon?
We can mix Hershey's?
Yes, you can. It will become a little chocolate flavor as well if you like to change the taste a little. If you want pure Oreo, then don't put Hershey's. You can use it for decoration on top. But since I like it a little chocolate Oreo, so I am putting a little chocolate sauce in this to make it a little light brown color. As well as a little chocolatey taste. Now, next step is I will fill this mousse in my piping bag. So, first thing is, since I'm using a nozzle, you have to ensure that your nozzle has a little broad mouth. If you have a very narrow nozzle, your mousse won't come out. So, ensure that you're using a broad, big mouth nozzle. So I'm cutting this icing bag first so that the nozzle goes in. According to the size of the nozzle, you will cut this. You have to ensure that the design part of the nozzle is out and this plain part is inside the bag.
Okay, ma'am, so see this.
Yes?
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes. Tell me.
I had the thing you are holding, piping bag.
No.
I had the top when the come the my mom has it in so but which ingredient did you ask? The we didn't ask.
Okay, no problem. So what you can do if you don't have the piping bag, you can directly put this into the glass and set with the spoon. No problem. So what I'm showing you is a little bit of presentation. So it will look better if you pipe it out with the nozzle. See, you will know the difference how it comes out. It comes out in a little design. So it looks better when it is put with the piping bag. It's more neat and the design also looks very good. So my piping bag is ready. Now I'll just get my things ready to assemble the dessert. So here's the glass. Next is the Oreo powder. There is powder remaining here. So what we will do, first we will put a first layer of mousse. See how it's coming out? It's coming in a design. So that's why I'm using a nozzle. This looks very nice. Okay, now on this, after putting a little bit of mousse, I'm going to sprinkle Oreo powder. So the Oreo crumbs here will give a layer of Oreo carefully in the middle. So the dark brown color in the middle will look very nice in the dessert glass. So that is why I said if you use a transparent glass, your layers of the dessert will be seen clearly. See, like this. So your light brown and your dark brown layers are seen very clearly. Now, again on top of this, I'm going to put a layer of mousse. So see, now you can see three, light brown, dark brown, and again light brown. Now we'll do the decoration.
Ma'am,
however you wish to do. Yes.
If we will not have wiping bag and nozzle, then we can use newspaper.
You can use butter paper cone or you can use a Ziploc bag. You can use any snack packet. You can put cream in that and use the corner of it for piping it out. And if you don't have any piping bag, no problem. You can just put with the spoon, you can put your cream and then put Oreo powder and then again with the spoon, put a neat layer of Oreo mousse.
Okay, ma'am.
Now on top for decoration, I am placing one Oreo biscuit. And I am placing some chocolates for decoration. This is optional. You can decorate it however you wish to. I'm putting some golden color sprinkler. This is also optional. You can do any decoration that you wish to do. So our Oreo mousse is ready. So here's our burger and here's our dessert. So does anybody have any questions? See, this is how it looks, three layers. All right, so if there's nobody who's making it along, no problem. You all can make it later. I hope you all have understood the recipe correctly, since you all don't have any questions. I hope you all enjoyed today's session.